Platelet-rich plasma. PRP stands for platelet-rich plasma. And platelet-rich plasma is prepared from your own blood. So it's actually a part of your blood. But what makes it special is within that fraction, which has a little bit of the plasma, which is the liquid part of your blood, and all the platelets, within that are what's called growth factors. Growth factors are the messengers that our body uses to communicate signals, in particular signals for healing. One growth factor helps bring in blood vessels. One growth factor helps bring in a type of cell called fibroblast, which lay down the matrix upon which healing occurs. And another growth factor stimulates stem cells to grab new cell growth. So where we apply PRP is in fat transfer situations. When we are taking fat that we've liposuctioned from one area of the body and putting it in another area of the body, like the breast or the buttocks, the key is getting the fat to survive. When we add PRP, we really increase the body's ability to help that fat survive, because now we've made the fat into what we refer to as smart fat. And it can actually call to it the blood vessels, the fibroblast, and activate the stem cells that helps make sure we have a good transplant result. Platelet-rich plasma has been used in the orthopedic world for maybe 5 or 6 years. It's just now coming to use in the cosmetic world. And we're going to see it more and more because of its healing abilities and its abilities to enhance the results from fat transfer. We could do PRP in just about any candidate. We could do PRP in every fat transfer candidate, and we try to encourage our patients to use it. The only downside of PRP is we have to draw the blood. And so if you're a tough person to get blood from, it can make it a little difficult to get the blood at the start, but that's really the only downside of the treatment.